The enormous mile-long K-25 plant used a method to separate uranium isotopes called gaseous diffusion. City of Oak Ridge historian Ray Smith explains how the gaseous diffusion process works.
It's a continuous operation, so it takes fewer people. In fact, you can operate K-25 on a tenth of what it costs to operate Y-12. That's one of the reasons that they shifted to that process. Now, how it works is you have a barrier material that's inside some stages where the gaseous process material is pumped through. And as it comes through, this barrier material that it passes through has lots of holes, very small holes. In a space the size of my thumbnail, you'll have 200 to 300 million holes. And they'll all be the same size, and they'll all be equally spaced. And as you push this material through in any one process step, that 235 will go through just a little faster than the 238. So at each of those 3,000 stages, you'll begin to accumulate a little bit more, a little higher percentage of the uranium-235. So this is a continuous operation process, pumps the material in gaseous form through a barrier material that has small holes, and accumulates a higher percentage of 235.
Manhattan Project veteran Donald Trauger worked on the design of the barrier for K-25. This allowed the U-235 isotope to pass through more easily than the stable isotope U-238.
I went to the Manhattan Project in New York at Columbia University and found that I was to work with the barrier, which was the separating membrane, which is the key to the process. The light element will diffuse through a very fine porous barrier a little bit faster than the uranium-238, which would not fission. But of course it required large areas of barrier and multiple stages to increase the concentration of uranium-235, the fissionable isotope, from 0.7%, as it is in nature, to above 90%, as was needed for a weapon. So that was a major task, and it was the key element in the K-25, what became the K-25 plant.